Hello everyone, welcome to the second topic on basic artificial neural network models. In this presentation, I will be covering you very basic primitive models like Mekula and Pitts neuron model, HEP network, perceptron network, Adeline, Madeline, and the problem associated with these models in terms of linear separability. Remember, for each of the model, I would like to introduce the architecture, net input calculation, output calculation, and weight updation process. Mekula and Pitts neuron model. The architecture for this neuron model may be some set of inputs that produces an output. The set of inputs may be or may not be supported with a bias. If it is associated with the bias, then the net input calculation over the output node will be like this: yn equal to b plus summation I equal to 1 to n xi wi. If it is without bias, that is for this model, the net input calculation is yin is equal to summation I equal to 1 to n xi wi. Once you have calculated the net input, the output is calculated with the help of any activation function. So the basic model of this MP neuron uses a binary step function where a threshold value is followed in which the data value, if it is greater than or equal to yin, it will always take 1. If it is less than data, it will take 0. So this kind of model is widely used in designing logic function. This is a simple working example for the MP neuron model. So you will be provided with the architecture like this, with the input values and the weight values, and you are asked to calculate the net input. See, this architecture is without bias. So the formula says that yin is equal to x1 w1 plus x2 w2 plus x3 w3. Upon substituting the values of x1 and w1 and do the calculation, you will be getting the net input like this. And the next example is how to calculate the net input with the bias. So you will be provided with the architecture like this, with the input values, the weight values, as well as the bias value. The input for the bias connection is always 1, it is constant input, and the weight value changes, and that weight is represented by the term b. So yn is equal to b plus x1 w1 plus x2 w2. This is the formula for calculating the net input of this given architecture. Upon substituting the value, you will get the net input of this particular neural network as 0.93. Now, it is our duty to calculate the output. So output calculation can be carried out with the help of any activation function. So while asking to solve or to find the output, they will be provided with an architecture. That architecture which has input, weights, and bias, or sometimes not bias. So and yeah, they have to mention the activation function. So as usual, you start with the net input calculation. Once the net input is calculated, then the net input value is substituted into the activation function expression to find the output. For this particular problem, the activation function given is binary sigmoidal function, so which has taken the expression 1 by 1 plus e to the power minus yin. So the final value is like this. Next, this particular MP neuron can be easily used to solve or realize a logical gate function. So this slide gives you how an AND function is implemented using MP neuron. For that, first you have to know the truth table of the AND gate. So here is the truth table, and you have to assume the initial weights W1 and WD as 1, because architecture is like this for this set of inputs. And for every category of input 1 1, we need to calculate the output. So if you produce 1 1 to this neural network model, and as per the formula, the output is 2. That means net input is 2. So like this you have to calculate. So now, after calculating net input values for all possible inputs, now you have to observe the pattern of the net input. Based on the pattern of the net input, you have to design the value of theta. So here, that pattern of the input is 2, 1, 1, 0. So if I choose the value of threshold theta as 2, then I may get this particular output with the help of the threshold, that is 1 if y in is greater than or equal to 2, or y in is less than 2 if it is 0. Then another model, HEP model. So in the previous McLaughlin's neuron model, only net input calculation and output calculation is carried out, and there is no space for weight updation process. The HEP, he is the scientist who observed that learning in human brain takes place by the change of synaptic gap. So he introduced the formula in addition to net input and output calculation with the help of an architecture. He introduced an expression for weight and bias updation. That is, new weight is equal to old weight plus some changing weight. And the changing weight is calculated as del W equal to Xi into Y. So this is particularly popularly used for bipolar data, and it is used for pattern association, classification and clustering. So this is an example of HEPnet. So the same AND function can be realized using HEPnet. Since it is bipolar, it is popular for bipolar data. Here the data taken is bipolar data with some bias. So when it is said that bipolar, instead of 0, you will be having minus 1. So for such kind of network, when you want to train this using HEP network, then you should design the initial weight values, and you have to calculate the net input, and over the net input you have to apply the activation function, and you have to produce the output. And for every type of input, you need to calculate the new weight by calculating the old, from the old weight as well as the product of Xi into Y, like this. Then the second set of input is produced. So you look at the table, for each set of input you have to update the weight values, and finally you will arrive at the particular set of weight values, and that weight values is the final weight value which has been used in the neural network model to produce the response. So this is what the architecture and the weight updation equation given by the HEPnet model. Next model, perceptor network. So now I devised the presentation like this. That is, you should understand the architecture, you should understand what is net input calculation and output calculation, as well as the weight updation formula. So the weight updation formula plays the pivotal role in understanding each neural network model. So net input calculation is the same as that of McLaughlin's model. Weight updation or output calculation is same as that of the previous models. That is, it can go for either threshold or it can use any activation function. But here, if you change the weight updation equation, the new weight is calculated as the old weight plus alpha into Tx. Now, alpha is a learning rate, T is a target, and X is the input. When coming to Adeline model, that is, Adeline is nothing but adaptive linear neuron, and it uses bipolar activation function. The rule followed in the Adeline is popularly called by the name delta rule, or least mean square rule, or otherwise called by the name Peterhof rule. Here the same net input calculation, output calculation are same with the architecture, but the one simple modification from the previous model in with that model is, here you are asked to calculate the error between the target, that is actual output, and the net input calculated in the output node. And the change in weight is calculated as a product of learning rate with the error and the set of input. So this particular approach is called by the name gradient descent approach. And if you look at the architecture, and this Adeline model is a single output unit model. There comes another model called Madeline, that is multiple adaptive linear neuron, where you are being provided with a set of nodes in the input layer, set of nodes in the layer called hidden layer, that is situated between the input layer and output layer, and a node, single node in the output layer. So here the output calculation is carried out by calculating the net input in two stages, one in the hidden layer stage, another in the output stage, and accordingly the expressions are given. So you have to use these expressions to calculate the input, first in the hidden layer, net input calculation in the hidden layer, and output calculation in the hidden layer, by means of either threshold or activation function, and then net input calculation in the output layer, and by means of some activation function or threshold, you have to calculate the output in the, that is the final output in the output. So these are the various primitive ANN models, and the problem associated with the ANN model is linear separability. So if you consider three different set of objects like this, if these different set of objects are separated by a single straight line, then the problem is said to be linear. I will explain it with the help of truth table of AND gate and AND gate. So now see the AND gate truth table and see the AND gate truth table. If I plot the values over x1 and x2 axis, you can divide the two categories. So what are the two categories of outputs? 0 is one category of output and 1 is another category of output. And these two category of outputs can be easily separated by a straight line. So if the problem is of this nature, then the problem is called linearly separable problem. In case, say for example, if you take the truth table of OR gate, then you might understood that the data patterns belonging to the output category may not be divided by a straight line. In this case, the problem is said to be non-linear. So why I am saying this particular problem in this particular presentation is, whatever the models we have seen so far are suitable only for this problem of linear separable nature, not for the problem of non-linear separable nature. For solving this non-linear separable problem of real world nature, we have to go for a back propagation neural network model that I will cover in the next presentation. So this is the contents I want to revisit again. So in all the 5 basic models, the change that occurred is in the weight updation equation. Of course, Hebb is the first scientist who introduced into the weight updation process, next to McLaughlin's. McLaughlin's have introduced only the net input calculation, output calculation with and without bias. The same is adopted by all the other models with a slight modification and introducing in the weight updation equation. The change in weight is calculated as the product of xi into y in case of Hebb network, and the change in weight is calculated in the term of alpha tx in the term of a perceptron network, and the change in weight is calculated as alpha into t minus y in into xi in case of Adeline network model, and in the same formula of Adeline is used in 2 layers, hidden layer as well as output layer, then it is Madeline model. And finally, we could see the problem of linear separability with the help of an XOR problem. So that's all. Thank you.